Hello everybody, my name is Eli Hollingsworth, and as always, welcome back to Against the Current, the Chosen YouTube channel, where today we are going to be discussing a very interesting topic when it comes to The Chosen Season 3, because as we all know, episodes 7 and 8 are coming to theaters, finally the season finale of Season 3 this Friday, and will be available until the next Monday, February 6th, and The Chosen has been explicitly saying on all of their social media campaigns to not spoil the big twist. Now, what does this mean? I don't know, but in this video, that's what we're going to speculate upon are my top 5 picks for what the big twist could be in The Chosen Season 3 finale. But before we begin, let's roll that intro. Now, I did ask people on the fan club and a few fan groups on Facebook for The Chosen, what other people think their prediction could be, and these are some of a few other people's predictions. And there's one thing in particular that I think is a lot of people have been mentioning, is that John the Baptist is going to be beheaded. Now, I don't think this is going to be a twist, because as always, you know, there's twists and turns in The Chosen, and they weave Bible stories into kind of the storytelling and the narrative of the show, and there's twists and turns. Always. There's always little surprises and things that are unexpected in the show. But the reason why I'm talking about this particular one, and the reason why this interests me so much, is because the reason that, why The Chosen would specifically say on all of their social media things, don't spoil the big twist. Like, they make a big notice of it. Why would they, you know, promote this so heavily? That means it's going to be something completely unexpected and something really, really, you know, mind-blowing. And John the Baptist being beheaded is something that we see happen in the Bible, and Jesus goes out on a boat, like, he goes, like, to be alone and to, like, he's very distraught about this. And we've seen in set photos, you know, a boat on the edge of a lake. So this is probably, you know, like, that's, I don't think that's going to be a twist. So I'm just mentioning that because I saw a lot of people thinking that. I don't think that's going to be a big twist, just a plot point that happens because that's what sets up, you know, the events of the feeding of the 5,000, is Jesus hears about John the Baptist being beheaded and then goes away, and then the people come and he preaches to them. So, just want to throw that out there. That is not going to be in my top 5 predictions. I didn't even consider that because it's not a big twist, just rather a plot point that is probably going to happen. But, with that said, my number 5 is Mary rejects Matthew. Now, we know there's going to be a scene where Matthew kind of confronts Mary and maybe confesses his feelings for her, and we've seen a few shots in the trailer of Matthew crying heavily while holding his, I think it's called a titzit, I finally learned the name of it, that little thing that hangs off of their Jewish shawls. It's like a part of the Jewish culture, they have to tie it onto their tunics or whatever. And he's seen in trailers holding that thing and crying heavily. So I don't know if this is just a, like, he's just crying because of his Jewish heritage, like he's looking back and having flashbacks. We know there's going to be a scene with a flashback of Matthew as a tax collector, where we see the shepherd from the Shepherds short. So maybe Matthew has a few flashbacks and is crying about something else, or this could be a shot of him crying because Mary maybe, like, says no. Maybe Matthew tries to, you know, confess his feelings, and the ship that's been being set up thus far in the show is maybe not going to end up happening. Number 4, Thomas and Rayma don't get married. This is one I saw a few people saying in the fan club, and it could happen. I mean, anything's possible with a big twist like this, which is being heavily marketed. We know Thomas is going to be in the season finale, so I don't know. I mean, this is a plausible one, and it would be very surprising and shocking and sad for sure, but I think someone said Dallas, I remember Dallas mentioning that there's going to be a wedding in season 3, and some people are theorizing that maybe it's not Thomas and Rayma's. Maybe it's my number 3 prediction, which is Barnaby and Shula's wedding. Now, I think there's something sacred to people of different genders just being friends in media. I think there's something sacred about that because a lot of times, you know, there's the common trope of two people, opposite genders, kind of start talking to each other and then it's like, oh, they always end up getting together. So I personally think there definitely is something sacred about two people just being friends and just kind of, because that's a real relationship that we have in real life. And right now, Barnaby and Shula are pretty much, I think, just friends. So that could be something that's fun to see, just kind of a different perspective of, or a dynamic of Barnaby and Shula just being friends. But it would also be cool to see them get married. Now that Barnaby has brought Shula to Jesus, and he healed Shula, and he also healed Barnaby, It would be cool to see kind of a resolution of their little mini sub arc this season to have them get married, and maybe that will be the wedding of the season 3 finale. Now, my number 2 prediction, this one is an interesting one, is that Leander is a spy. Maybe Leander, because again, before Leander was introduced, a lot of people were thinking that he was going to be the guy, I forget his name, whoever was cast lots upon the disciples after Judas committed, you know, to be like the new disciple. He was one of those people, and a lot of people were theorizing that that was who this man in orange, Leander, was going to be. And it turns out that his name is Leander. So maybe he changes his name, I don't know, but maybe he is also a nefarious character. Because he was at the Feeding of the 5,000. He's probably definitely going to be an important recurring character for the rest of the show, which means you're going to probably see him again. But I don't know if he... Maybe it'd be cool to see a little twist, like he's a Roman spy or a Pharisee spy or something. Maybe another nefarious party who's kind of watching Jesus. I think it'd be interesting to see if Neander is not all that he claims to be. And maybe we learn a little bit about that in the season finale. But my number one pick, and this one, it may be a little bit out of the blue, but it's something that I saw someone else suggest. I don't know who it is. Sorry, I want to give credit, but I don't unfortunately remember who it is. And if you are watching and you are this person, then make sure to let me know. But what if, this is my number one prediction, for the big twist of the season 3 finale, and that is that Atticus is actually the one who the centurion's servant needs to get healed. Now, saying it out loud, it does seem a little bit like maybe not as, you know, it'd be a little bit maybe a little bit too like subversive for subversive sake. Like, oh, it's been set up this whole time to be Gaius, and he's been a sympathetic character, and he's, you know, kind of having a change of heart, especially in season 3. And then all of a sudden be like, whoops, well, it's leading you along to Gaius, but it's really Atticus. Like, that would be maybe a bit harsh. And like, you know, just, again, subversive for subversive sake, which would not be the greatest thing for the Chosen to do. And they've never really been known to do stuff like that, but I think it would be interesting. And now, thinking about all the evidence that's been set up for Gaius... That would be pretty mean to be like, whoops, it's Atticus. But it is a possibility, and it's something that would be very surprising and very shocking to see that Atticus is actually the centurion whose servant needs healing and goes to Jesus for it. Because Atticus is really interested in Jesus in this season. And he's very much scouting him out. Or, you know, the other theory I have is the whole show could be just a dream, one of Pilate's wife's dreams. None of it's real, none of it's happening. It's just Pilate's wife dreaming away. I'm just kidding, obviously, that's not a real prediction that I have. So what did you think? Do you think that I'm crazy? Do you think that I'm right? Do you think I'm wrong? Well, I guess we'll have to see this week when The Chosen Season 3, Episodes 7 and 8, come to theaters on February 2nd and last until February 6th. Make sure you go check it out. It's going to be an amazing experience. These episodes are going to be phenomenal, as The Chosen usually is. And, of course, again, you can see me in the episodes for a total of 30 seconds. I don't know how long a minute, but I'm guessing it won't be more than that. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and make sure to leave a like if you like this video. And I mean, seriously, if you want to see more content with me and be notified and be the first one to see, because the first people to watch my videos and comment, I will be much more likely to respond to rather than later, you know, after it's been out for a while. So if you want to be responded to by me, then be sure to comment down below as quick as you can and to subscribe and turn that notification bell so you can watch my videos as early as you can. And thank you for watching so much, and I'll see you in my next video. Goodbye. I was wondering if you found me, I was not the one you see, and the only thing that happened was this stranger.